Hi guys, here we are in Manila International Airport. We just touched down not long ago. We're going to do a conduct research. We're going to build a house and see how research go. Our research about the integrity values of the villages of Gawad, Kalinga. Yep.
Initially, most of us had the impression that Gawad, Kalinga was rather undeveloped. Our research project was to find out on the integrity values of the villages. We were to place wallets at different locations in the village and wait for the locals to return it to us. We had a feeling that the villagers were not very honest and feared that they would fail the test. We also thought they were not very sociable. However, when we arrived at the village, the first impression was very different from what we had expected.
Thank you.
Hey, hi, now I'm at the village already, and look at the welcoming response of the children. My goodness, you know, they really came and just, you know, gave us all these things and even, you know, made real orange juice for us. It's really good, seriously.
Hi guys, and now we are going on a tour, but just now before that we had a little talk by Ricky, Uncle Ricky, and he gave us a brief summary about the history of Philippines and how this whole village came about, and now he's gonna show us around and see what happens.
As we walked along, we were given a tour of the village, which had a very beautiful array of houses. The village children focused their attention on us, showering their care and concern. They held our hands and played many games with us. Many of them talked to us while we were going around and asked us many questions. The villagers also invited us into their homes. One of them was a candy maker called Tito Noynoy. He invited us into his humble abode and shared with us how his life as a candy maker was and the transformation process from sugarcane to sweet that he made possible.
We are here in one of the villagers' house. This is roughly about one of the houses. There's many more of this kind. Inside, behind us, there's a few rooms there. Basically, what they do is they make their own candy. This is actually homemade candy products by them. They make it behind in their own backyard, and it's dried up sugar cane, which is very delicious. And they sell this chopsticks of this for 10 pesos.
Yeah. I would like to dedicate this song to all of you here.
Thank you.
Let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be.
Yeah, you inspired that song.
Let it be.
Yeah, happy Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Same here.
We met up with the hay farmer Jonathan, a really nice guy who shared his experience tending the farm. Other than organic farming, he does vermiculture, which is the usage of earthworms to create fertilizer. This makes the organic farm self-sufficient and is able to sustain the village. After the fruitful trip to Gawad, Kalinga, we realized that the simplicity of life was more satisfying than having all the riches in the world. As hospitable hosts, they allowed us into their lives, sharing with us their culture. The honesty and integrity was really an eye-opener for us as they returned all the wallets that we accidentally dropped. Gawad, Kalinga has most certainly proven itself to be able to transform these villages through the building of new homes. Gawad, Kalinga has established itself as an instrument of change for the Philippines.
But these places and these faces are getting old. I said these places and these faces are getting old. So I'm going.